Hello, good evening. How are you doing today? We are going to discuss about an important topic called as Vasya. The Vasya is a very important concept in astrology, and that is mainly used for marriage compatibility, in also selecting your partner for marriage, or if you are doing business, then you can take a business partner for that instance. And if you are looking for a girlfriend and you don't know which girlfriend would be suitable for you, then it would be applicable. It is also applicable for the friends. How you will choose the friends is also depend on this Vasya sign only. So we have to understand the five the rules which are applicable for understanding the Vasya sign. So there are totally five rules which are applicable. The rule number one, the signs owned by the planets with the same the bhutas or Vasya signs to each other. But if two signs are owned by the same planet, then the rule is applicable only if the sign of the sign is the first, which is starting from Aries, or if the sign is in a Mola Trikona sign. And you should note here that the sun and moon do not have any Buddhadipatya, which is assigned to them. So they don't have any Buddhas. And if Lord of the sign is, rule number two, if the Lord of the sign is debilitated in some sign, then that sign could be a Vasya sign to the first one which we are considering as Vasya. This rule is applicable only to the sign that is the second. That is second, if two signs are being owned by the same planet from starting from Aries, or to the sign that is not Mola Trikona for any planet, then only this particular thing has been considered. The third one is for the sign which are Swakshetra for the same planet, means own Rashi of the same planet or Vasya signs to each other. But if two signs are owned by the same planet, then this rule is applicable only to the sign which is first, one of those two which is starting from Aries. If a planet is considered, if the planet is exalted in the considered sign, whichever you are considering, then the sign owned by the planet, by that exalted planet, could be a Vasya sign. But this rule is again having an exception, that the sign owned by the exalted planet should come as third, fourth or the sixth from the considered sign. So, from that considered sign, this particular planet, exalted planet, should come as third, fourth or the sixth from the considered sign. And the fifth rule is, if a planet is debilitated in the considered sign, then the sign owned by the planet could be Vasya sign. So, this rule is again applicable only if the sign is owned by the debilitated planet which is coming in the third, fourth or the sixth of the considered sign. So, if you consider these rules, now if we take Aries for example, so Aries will have a but actually if you see majority of the Vasya signs, you can easily solve from the first two rules itself. But some of the Rashis will make confusion, that is why all these five rules are applicable. For example, if Aries, if you take the rule number one, there will be nobody. But if you take the rule number two, then if the Lord of the sign is debilitated in some sign, then sign could be the Vasya sign for the first. So here if you see, the Vasya signs will be Leo and Scorpio for the Leo and Scorpio for the Rashi, for the Aries. So the Vasya for Aries would be Leo and Scorpio. Now why we have selected Leo and Scorpio, which is a Vasya sign for the first? This would be the question for everybody. So I am going to give an explanation to you, for you to understand what is Vasya signs better. Leo, the Lord of the Leo is exalted in Aries, if you understand, and Aries and Scorpio is ruled by the same planet. So what you have understood from this is, if any planet is getting exalted in a sign, then the sign ruled by the planet could be a Vasya for that planet. If lot of two signs are the same, then the second sign could be a Vasya sign for the first one, and vice versa if it repeats. So for Taurus, Libra and Cancer, or for Taurus, the Libra and Cancer could be Vasya signs. Why? Because Cancer, if you see that the if any planet is exalted, which is Lord of Cancer, is, you know that it is Moon, which is exalted in Taurus. So Taurus becomes, the Cancer becomes the Vasya sign for Taurus. And Libra, the Taurus and Libra is ruled by the same planet, which is Venus. So it is automatically becoming a Vasya sign. But question will remain, when it, you are coming to the Scorpio, where the Scorpio's Vashya Rasi is Cancer. But here you should know that the Lord of Cancer is debilitated in Scorpio. But why then Rishis have mentioned that Rashi and the Cancer and the Scorpio is Vashya Rashis? Because both of them are reptile in nature. Reptiles means they are, the Rashi itself, both of them are reptiles, and the Lord of the Scorpio is getting debilitated in Cancer, so there is a very strong connection between these two signs, and it is called as Vasya signs. So they get automatically attracted to each other when it is going to the Cancer. For Lord of Cancer, then the Scorpio would be an attracted sign. So this is how the Vasya signs are being understood and taken. So these particular five rules which I have given will be helpful for you to understand what is Vasya, and this particular Vasya rules you can use it for your own five, for choosing your marital partner, to choose your compatibility between your partner. So it could be either a Lagna Lagna Rashi or Moon Rashi. So if it is Moon Rashi, it is related to the mind. If it is Lagna Rashi, then it is related to the body. So either way, you have to check whether you are compatible with your business partner, whether you are going to be a, whether the boyfriend or the girlfriend what you have chosen is correct or wrong. And it is also helpful to choose your good friends. So by this way, it has been distinguished that Vasya signs logic in astrology. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity again. I hope you have understood this lesson nicely. If any doubts or anything, do let me know for me to clarify more. In the meanwhile, I request all of you to kindly subscribe my channel so that I keep posting many interesting videos for you to understand this logic. So in future, I may give some of the case, some of the quizzes for marital compatibility. Then you should know that why a marriage has been failed in the first instance, that this particular the thing has not been put into consideration. Thank you.